Let's start today's project by casting on about 5 or 6 rows of scrap yarn. Open the door, trim off the scrap yarn, drop it into the middle. I'm going to pick up my first color. And for this particular project with the rainbow fingerless gloves, I'm going to do red. And for the red, I'm going to knit 7 rows. I'm using my power drill with the attachment to the Addie machine. If you're interested, I have those linked in the description below. I'm going to move on to my second color. This color will be 6 rows. I'm going to stop here for a moment and I'm going to tie my colors together where I had the color change. I don't knot them too tightly, just enough to close the hole. I'm going to load my next color, and this is also going to be 6 rows knitted. Next color, 6 rows. Tying them as I move along, keep everything organized. Each color is 6 rows. Finishing off the gloves with the red, and this will be 7 rows to match the first 7 rows from the first red that I put on. I'm just trimming off the color change yarn from where I already tied them, just to keep everything organized. And then I'm gonna put on about 5 or 6 rows of scrap yarn. Next, to get this to come off my machine, all you need to do is cut and drop your yarn in the middle of your machine. And all you need to do is first make sure your drawer is closed on your adding machine so you don't break it. Spin it and your project will just fall off. Okay, so I'm just grabbing my crochet hook. I believe I grabbed the 5mm hook. I'm just looking at the sizes here. Take your tube and you want to stretch it out. Now choose an end, it doesn't matter which end, and you want to have the tails of the yarn in your left hand. Here you can see me just lining up the end of the tube. And we're going to close the tube from right to left. So you can see the scrap yarn which is white and then the red. So here I am just getting a little bit closer. What you're going to do is take the very top loops and you're going to just simple crochet, pull each one from the left under to the right under back to the left, and you're just taking the top knit. And you just want to take your time doing this. You don't want to miss any, otherwise you're going to have a drop stitch. You can fix it if you do miss one. And you just want to make your way across the tube until you reach the other end. I'm just coming to the end of the work here. And again, you just want to take your time and make sure you're grabbing the top loops. And then I always grab the very one on the end. Sometimes a little difficult to grab, but you just have to take your time and then pull the tail that you left through, and that knots the top of your work. And then you're just going to remove your scrap yarn. Now, just a little note here. One side of the scrap yarn is always easier to take off than the other. Some people choose to cut their scrap yarn. If you do this, just be really careful you don't cut your actual project work. But if you can get it out in one piece, then you can save it for your next project, which I always try to do, and I always seem to catch a knot. Not at the end here, and I just trim it off and then pull off the rest. So measuring these again, you can add more rows or take away rows depending on how long you want this. Here I'm just showing you it's about 7 inches by 9 inches, and what you're going to do is you're going to take your tube, you're going to fold it in half. So you can see the length of how long this would be on my arm, from the forearm to about midway in my fingers. So again, you're going to fold your tube in half. You're going to take the long end that you left, putting on a darning needle here, Now you have your tube and you fold it like a sandwich. And what you want is you want to get those V knitted all lined up. And you just want to have one line here. I'm just checking it again. I'm kind of eyeballing where I'm going to put the opening for my thumb, and it looks like it's going to land right on the purple, which is perfect. So again, fold it in half like a sandwich. You can actually see I have a couple of dropped stitches there, which are easy to fix. You just want to grab it. Now, to join this together, you're going to do a mattress. So you're just going to do two at a time. Loop it through the first and then move up one. Loop it through the next two. I'm grabbing my drop stitch here. Easy fix. And then you just want to move on to the next one all the way up. You want to take your time here. You don't, again, want to miss any stitches because then you're going to have holes and it's just not a pretty look. This goes pretty quickly. Because I have colors, changing colors throughout my project here, I also want to make sure I'm grabbing the loops and they're lined up so the colors, you know, stay together. So I'm just going to speed this up here. Now I'm coming up to where the thumb hole is going to be, and I eyeballed, measured it, and it's going to be at the purple. So I just put the last stitch in right at the base of that purple. I'm going to put it on. I'm just going to double check, making sure that's where I want it, and that's exactly where I want it. So everyone will be different. You just have to put it on, and this is what it looks like when you start closing it. It looks very nice. Now you should use the same color, and obviously this is multicolored, so it's a little bit more difficult, but once you put the yarn through the loops, it pretty much gets hidden. So I just reinforce the bottom, I pull it across, and then you just want to push up your needle underneath the V stitch just to where you're going to have the opening to your thumb and pull it through. And then you're going to go across right where you want the thumb hole to end. And then you just want to go two by two for the rest of the length of your project. And when you come to the end, you just want to make sure you've got a clean edge there. And then you'll just tie it, and then you can pull the stitches, yarn through the part of the project so you don't see the tails anymore. And then you're done. So there you go. There is the finished length of the seam with your thumb hole. I'm just hiding the leftover yarn, trying it on one more time, cutting off the excess, and you have a pair of fingerless gloves. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and happy knitting.